Hello? Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. This is Delirious. At you live with some comedy flats. Now, guys, listen. I'm only going to be doing Shirley for like a short time. In about 30 minutes, I'll be switching to a commission for a commissioner for Lo-Fi Girl on a body pillow. So, what better way to set the mood than to have music for inspiration? Am I right? If you guys can hear me, let me know. But yeah, welcome to the channel. Awesome. Thanks, TransStation. I really appreciate it. I'm glad that you can hear me. That means my other customer will be able to hear me as well. This is fantastic. I think the only complaint on my end is that I can actually hear myself, so I'm not sure. How I can actually get away from that reverb, because I'm using my earphones, and I shouldn't be hearing myself talk. Thank you. anything, you'll have to wait. The goblin, he's definitely new. He's definitely going to be a part of the story, and that's about all I can say about him. So for those of you who don't know, I started Shirley back in 2015, and I actually finished season one, and season one is about Stan and Melrose, which are who I'm drawing from. A little goblin on the bottom is extra, and he's in Shirley Fairy Tale. Let me tell you, I went all the way out. So, like, season one of Shirley is actually 20 issues long, and then I have season two, and it's called Shirley Fairy Tales, and I got about up to chapter 9 with that, and then I had to go on a 3-year break. Depression, and then I got myself some help. I got on some medication, and I healed from that. Now, it took me about 3 years to be able to, come off of the medication and finally be, you know, to finally heal, but, it's been great. I've been writing again. I've been getting into, other things. I've also been into TikTok lately. I've been watching a lot of TikTok, more of, you know, actually posted anything. I've been pretty lazy about that, but I've also been, you know, kind of looking at what other people post and thought about what I should post as an artist, and that's pretty much what it is. In that time, I've been healing, and another thing that actually helped me to heal is So when I started Shirley, I was, I used to work for Life Touch Studios, as a... and that was about the time, when I started, and then I actually had to go take that 3-year break. What I ended up learning is that, I was not happy where I was. So, we ended up quitting, my husband and I, because we worked together, we ended up having to leave Life Touch just because it was, they started, you would think that a company would recognize its workers, you know, and how hard they were, because we would go out of our way to go to places, like, we went all the way to Missouri, I think, at one point in time. We went to Florida, we went to a lot of places, you know, and they still wanted to get rid of us. You know, they still got rid of us. Now, you know, it's not my manager's fault, really. The guy that we actually work for, the regional manager, loved us, and he scheduled us everywhere, and we were his go-to people, because it's like, oh, well, nobody else wants to go anywhere or can't do anything, so he sent us. And we're like, yeah, sure, we're happy to go wherever you want. We like to travel a lot. Then our regional managers ended up changing out, and we're like, and she started hiring new people and giving them all the other spots, and then the people who were supposed to schedule it, the people that she's going through to schedule our places to go and take pictures, they weren't very good, and we couldn't get anybody to buy pictures, so we ended up leaving. And, I mean, in that one little stint, there was, you know, we were just kind of waiting to go back to work because it's, you know, and you can't really have another job while you're waiting on work. So when we find, so we finally said, you know, hey, we called, my husband called one day and said, hey, do you have any work for us or anything like that? Because there are a lot of people getting on, there are a lot of people, you know, getting that, and we're not. And she said, no, I don't have anything. This is January. She's like, no, I don't have any jobs for you guys to go to. And we said, okay, well, then we quit. We're done. We're not gonna work for you guys anymore. And she said, okay, that's fine. I understand. It's like, listen, it's like, we can't wait around for that. She's like, okay, well, just go ahead and just submit your resignation. We never submitted our resignation. We said, listen, we're gonna quit. But yeah. Well, hello, Bastras. I cannot pronounce your name. I'm just gonna call you BT. But welcome, BT. Bastries Twitch. I think I'm pronouncing that right. And yeah, I mean it's not necessarily horrible. It's just, you know, I don't trust corporations anymore. They don't treat us like normal people. So when we go out of our way to do things, I expect to get paid for it. And rather well on top of that. And that didn't happen, so we left. Anyway, fast forward, you know, my husband Josh finds another job. I'm able to work with them a little bit off and on because it's a t-shirt design place. And it worked out for a little while. And then she, like, a couple years later, she retired, said, I'm done. Ended up selling it to somebody, the business of somebody else. My husband, of course, you know, only lasted for so long until he was replaced, even though he ran the place for, you know, a long time. But of course, again, management changed, so, or ownership changed, so, he left. But in the midst of all that, I decided, you know, I had made some friends, right? So, like, I've been going, since I started Shirley, I actually did go and start printing comics and stuff like that, and I found a way to print them, and I've been going to conventions, and I made friends, and, one thing after another, I met this really cool lady. Her name is Robin, and she's amazing. And one day she was at the local flea market in town, which happens to be it's a special flea market. Like, this is the kind of flea market that you go to find unique stuff. Like, yeah, sure, you know, like, you can find, it's not just an antique shop, but you can find all kinds of cool stuff, like comics and toy, like, new toys, old toys, nostalgic stuff, but also artists sell there as well. And of course, she said, hey, you know, you should check out this market and sell there. And I said, Robin, nobody wants to buy art, original art, at a flea market, and if they do, I'm not going to get that much money. Well, she still convinced me to get a table anyway, and I said, all right, fine, whatever. I made $50 the first, you know, I made $50 before, what was it? Before lunch, and that was September 2020. I was nuts. I was convinced, so I ended up showing up every day, and then eventually at the table, because there are two types of, let me back up and explain the barnyard. There are two types of setups you can get. You can either show up every weekend and set up a table and stay there, and then you can pack up and leave, which, if you do that every day, can be an absolute pain in the ass. If you do it, but or you could pay a certain amount every month and you could get a shop, full-blown shop. So I stuck it out, and from September 2020 all the way up until now, I've gone from a table in 2 months or 4 months to having a shop for a full year. So I've got like art all across the walls. I just decided to go on ahead and get a Cricut Maker or a Cricut Explorer because stickers and vinyl, and that's popular right now. And I want to make Shirley stickers and vinyl and stick that all over my car and then sell that stuff to all my customers. But yeah, so I have my own business now. It's kind of crazy. I don't think I'll ever, unless something happens, the place shuts down, you know, and corporations are the only way anybody can make a business anymore. I highly doubt that, but, yeah. So I started that, and that's helped me. That's helped me a lot for the past year to heal. So, thank you, Barnyard Flea Market, for being awesome, and thank you, Robin, for convincing me to get a shop. I'm gonna tell you something, y'all. Don't ever let anybody ever tell you that you can't make a living by yourself. With all of the resources we have online and after, we're not, you know, you can start your own business and you can start making money. I don't care if somebody tells you that, oh, you can't do that. Well, they're wrong because they don't understand. But with things like, I don't know, whatchamacallit, things like Etsy, stores like Etsy, Facebook, you can get a store now. Instagram, you can get a store now. TikTok, well, the whole thing, well, TikTok made me buy it. Which, by the way, there are a couple of things that I've seen on TikTok that look really nice and I want to get. But, regardless, I'm going to start doing that with my stuff, too. Y'all be, like, looking at TikTok and be like, oh, yeah, Melissa made me buy it. Which, by the way, is my real name. It's not Delirious.
But when everything is coming back together,
but yeah, normally I don't turn my mic on.
I don't
talk, but I'm working on changing that. By the way, if you kind of hear me like going in the middle of whatever I'm doing, talking and arting, I am not good at, even though I used to do caricatures. For Busch Gardens, Florida. The people who do caricatures and can talk, holy crap. It's like, oh, you're talking. And you have to distract your person and charm them into doing your... No, man! If you can't charm your... If you can't... I would just rather just, like, do the art. And if... I'd just rather shut up and do the art. If you look at my work, I shouldn't have to convince you of buying it. I should, you know, you should be able to look at it, see it, and be like, oh yes, that's my work. I like that. Or that's Melissa's work. That's great. I want to buy that. that's just me. Or some people sit in the chair and be like, they think they know what they want and they don't. I think my favorite is, can you do portraiture? We cannot do portraitures. Well, can you draw Batman? I'll draw you a Batman, but it's gonna be a caricature Batman. You like caricature Batman? Sometimes I draw them as caricature, you know, as a caricature in Batman, or as a Batman caricature, or whatever. That's what we're supposed to do anyway. But every so often, somebody will come up and be like, I don't want you to draw me. I want you to draw this guy instead. Okay, $50. Yeah, caricaturing is, there any artists out there who want to learn speed with their profession and get good at the same time? Because you will. Get that speed down, you will get better time, and it will thrive and grow. It will be amazing as you draw, but be ready for some people who are like, but that's okay, if they don't like it, you can just crumble it up and be like, alright, bye. Because we're not supposed to take anything, we're not really allowed to keep any that's rejected. I mean, we can, I guess, but legal purposes, you know? Alright. Save that and now we're gonna go now that all that's saved give me about 5 minutes. And I'm gonna see if Mr. Garrett, oops, probably shouldn't have said his name out loud, see if my customer is, gonna give him like a 5 minute heads up. Unless that is you, BT. Oh yeah, I love it. That's weird. Hey, Hey, BT, are you my commissioner? Oh my god. Good. Okay, cool. So now that you've heard, like, my life story, and since you're here. Awesome. Yeah, I just sent it to you. Sorry, I didn't know that you. That. I didn't know that you. That was you. Alright, I'm gonna. As you can see, I've already gotten the, the background made. So. Well, I'm glad that you're here. I was like, there's a new guy. There's a newcomer here. I just don't know who he, I don't know who they are. But, I'm glad. So, and I'm excited too. Lord Kida. Hi! Blarg. What's a blarg? Y'all gotta understand, I'm well, I mean, that's just how things are. And I appreciate it. I, you know, if it wasn't for my friend Robin, I wouldn't have, make it out. And what I'm gonna just lay a new thing I like. Add height. Okay. Yeah, me too. Yes. Yeah, I know it's a noise, and yeah, I did blarg. And yeah, me too. I just, man, there are companies out there that really do care about their employers, and they will go up above and beyond to ensure that they stay. Before I went and did the photography thing at Life Touch, I actually was a Life Touch person before the photography thing. I helped do all of their color correction, photo manipulation and what I'd like to call retouch light, which they get a bunch of people together. They get a group of people together for the retouch light, and they, as a department, and they're all temporaries. Like, I was a temporary, but they love me so much, they're like, you know, if you want to stay, we'll give you a permanent desk job, and you can be part of the skeleton crew. I'm like, oh, really? They're like, yeah. It's like, you know, we notice that, you know, we take notice that you really love your job, and we love what you do, and you work really hard. And I'm like, you don't understand what this company means to me. Because I've drawn all my life, and then back in 2000, after I graduated high school and went into college, almost immediately they put me in a graphic design program, and they taught me Photoshop. And once I got over my learning curve, there was no stopping me. I learned so much, and I did so much, and, like, you know, it was more than just me flexing in, like, I've never really had a job where I could actually go into. Right? Yeah, and I'll get into that in a little bit. I was working, I did about 1,000. Like, when I did the retouch light thing, it was just basically, like, retouching a whole bunch of photos. Like, amateur photos, I think, just, like, offshoots. But, offshoots. But, I did... whatchamacallit, I did about 1,000 pictures per day, or night. I worked the night shift, and like I said, I mean, they liked me so much, and even the boss there was just like, oh my god, you're so amazing, and they're like, you know, I said this place, and I told the boss, I'm like, boss, this is more than just a job for me. This is almost like a playground. Like, everything that you have me in, I can do. And then you put me with people that you know, have known Photoshop since it became Photoshop. Like, they were graphic designers and did all that before Photoshop came out. So we're talking about women in their 50s that have done this, like, most of their life. The person, the lady that I had the pleasure of working with, was, I think how she actually did, the retouch, the old school way, was taking film, right? And putting it under a magnifying glass, dipping a, dipping a very sharp pointed pen, like a thin brush, into some green paint, and then putting all the blemishes, taking all the blemishes out with the green paint under the magnifying glass. If that's not nuts, I don't know what is. Welcome back. So I was just like, yeah, I don't. It's like, I, you know, and I soaked up everything that she gave me. I'm like, give it to me. Give it all to me. She's like, you're like a rock star. I'm like, you don't understand. I absolutely adore Photoshop and all of its capabilities. I cannot stop. People talk about, oh, well, you know, they come into my shop and they're like, oh, you have a passion, you have that. I'm like, I don't know if it's really called a passion or if it's just compulsatory, because I could never see myself ever not drawing. Like, I'm probably never going to actually retire. I am trying to choose a pose, but, do you have anything? I'm glad. But yeah. I'm just gonna be one of those people that work until I die. That's pretty much it, just because I can't see myself. Unless something happens and I just can't paint anymore, and then I'll just be like, you know what, that's okay. I don't, you know, if it gets to the point to where my hands or my head starts shaking, I'll be like, you know what, that's alright. I'll just go back to traditional painting, and you know what, I'll use all of those other strokes to be like, I'll start doing impressionism or something. I'll be like, yeah, that's right. I just made lemonade out of lemons. Morgan? Like, when you say Gorgon, are you talking about, the one from that one series, Stranger Things? Hey, BT, I couldn't remember, but did you want her in a hoodie? Yeah. It's all good, dude. Speed comes with time. I know that's weird. Also, caricatures? That's actually where I get my speed from. Did you want the hoodie on, BT? Or did you want, the hoodie down? Thank you. You can take a picture of the QR code and it'll give you all my handles so you can actually see where I'm, you know, like what I'm doing. So the weekend shop is my own art and my thing. The caricatures, I used to live in Florida. I am originally from South Central Florida, and I moved to Tampa. Tampa, that's where Busch Gardens, Florida is. And then that's also where I went to college at. I actually have a degree in animation. When I went, after I graduated, there was a position at Busch Gardens, Florida that opened up. And it was by a company in Busch, within Busch Gardens, and within a lot of, what was it? A lot of the theme parks and amusement parks called, Commons Art Shops. Commons Art Shops is very famous for their face paints, or their face paintings, their woodworking, and their airbrush, and also caricatures. And that's where I learned that from. And that, so, like, I already knew. I already knew how to draw, right? So, like, I just needed to learn how to do the style. That was one hell of a ride. But yeah, Busch Gardens. That's where I started out at. And then when my husband and I, realized we had, when we realized we had our taxes come in and we could actually move, my husband's like, because we bought a whole bunch of stuff, and I was like, this is so awesome. And he goes, you know, we started talking about it. It's like, hey, you know, because like we had just gotten our tax refund. He goes, you know what? Are you interested in really staying here? Do you want to stay here? I said, no. But of course, and then it had dawned on me. I'm like, wait, we can leave? Yeah, if you want to. Like, yes, I want to leave. Yes, I want to leave. So, I told my boss I wanted to leave, and he said, listen, I can get you and your husband a gig over at Carolyn's for the summertime, since spring is almost over, and, they're about to get into their full-blown thing. I said, are you okay with that? He's like, yeah, I understand you want to get out of here, it's hot. Personally, I'm not really for other places, but, like, yeah, you can finish your thing out there, and then you can find another job elsewhere. I said, that's awesome. And that's exactly what I did. Okay. Funny stories? No. Well, there was this one time I was told that I was a Mexican because I worked like one. And that was, my bosses from Carowinds. Also, I had no idea that you were... I thought you were from Texas. And not Florida. She needs rabbit ear. She needs, like, bunny slippers, so I'm gonna put bunny slippers. If that's alright. I gotcha. From Texas. Currently in Pensacola. That's the army life, isn't it? Or Navy. Military. Y'all travel a lot. And Pensacola's not too bad. You're in the panhandle. You can leave the States and go to another place whenever you want. That is awesome. Are they pink too? Are the bunny slippers pink? By the way, if I haven't said anything earlier, thank you for your service. We greatly appreciate what you guys do. Me and my husband both. I got the courage for it. And I don't even... I know we're not probably supposed to get into any political stuff, but it's like I almost kind of I'm not worried. Cool. I don't know. So like I'm sure everybody's. Oh, you're not a soldier? Sorry, I. I gotcha. I know a lot of people who, I know a lot of people who are in the military, so when I hear that they're. When I hear that they moved, I thought you were a soldier. Sorry. Okay. I gotcha. Okay, so question. Do we want the hoodie down and have headphone and so it will reveal her headphones? Or do you want it up? Everybody caught fire. Rock on. Everything caught fire. But speaking of which, we're probably not supposed. I'm just gonna go on ahead into it. So, Russia. Do you think they're gonna invade Ukraine, or you think everybody's just playing, you know, like both ends are just playing chicken? And they're not gonna really do anything. I really hope that nobody goes to war because that would be bad. Also, I like Russian folklore and because that's what my comic is based off of, and from that part of the country, it's actually based on, Russian folklore, and I would love to visit Russia someday. And Putin's being a jerk. Okay. How do you like it? Because I'm about to go. I like. Is there anything that you want changed? Because I'm about to go into some inks. I hear ya. forget. Or I forget. I am interested. What is AA? It's Artist Alley. Durr. Ugh. I saw a TikTok on, TikTok. Said, that's fine, you can, something about, it's like, oh, yeah, I like stuff, yeah, give me stuff. Don't worry about what you know. Don't worry about having too much or too less of something. You like something, you like something. Well, I appreciate it. I started out commissioning a couple of years ago, and then, you know, I figured out, you know, it's a fair price. But I appreciate it. Alright. How is everything now? Are we good? Alright, sweet. I'm gonna save this right quick, again. This program hasn't crashed on me at any, like, at all yet, so... Thank you. good night. What a nut. That is... Wow. What? I'm still not sure what I'm reading. The kid did what? Oh my god. Wow. Wow. You know, that is an angry, spoiled little brat. I think when YouTube was getting kind of big, there's a kid, there are two brothers. The brother, the older brother, was, I don't know what he was, but he threw some major tantrums, and his brother would always record him. But I'll tell you the type of things that this kid argued over, or whined about, or really just made temper tantrums over, was the color of his car. That's bad. We don't need no education. The writing's on the wall. No, don't think I need anything at all. Wow. Thank you. I forgot to mention, thank you for paying me what you did. I actually tried to bring my prices up and right before Christmas and stuff, and of course I didn't fly with the other customer, and they're like, sorry. So that's why I brought them down. I did try. remember that. So, get this. I actually had, I had a friend. This is at the Barnyard Flea Market. I had a friend that actually used to own a place in the Barnyard Flea Market, and he had a video store because he full of monster movies because he loves monster movies and everything. By the way, plop a thing. I can plop a link. The Patreon. Just started getting into Shirley Fairy Tales, because it's like, you'll have like a full 20 issues. You'll have a full 20 issues of Shirley, and then, for the Patreon, and then February we're going to be getting into, Shirley Fairy Tales. So, I think I can pull that up right quick. Still learning. Oh. So here's the whole thing. I'm gonna let you look it over. I have to fix that, and then I'll go Shirley. Save. There we go. Alright. So, I just dropped Shirley in there. But yeah, I don't know if you guys know about Clip Studio, but the EX version not only helps me get comics done like so much faster, I used to do all my comics in Photoshop. That was, oh god, that was a pain. Now I can actually animate in it, and I'm excited about that because, like I say, I actually have a degree in animation, and I can do that now. It's so nice, and I can color. Like, I can color my comics, and it's just so magical. So magical! up Studio Paint. I'm gonna make these just slightly lighter so you can actually see, like, the color and everything. Like, when I say color, like, you can see the transition through, like, the darks and the lights and everything. Or the darks and the light. Glad you like her. Was it a cow? And sure, I'll be right back. Bathroom break. Thank you. I'm not. Yeah, I actually don't make the pillow myself, train station. That's another guy. And yeah, the people that contacted me, his name is Otaku Junkie. Great guy. I actually talked to him in person. I never actually turned it off because, the bathroom's far away enough, but like I'm back. Purple Monster plush. So you want to talk about funny stories? Well, the first time I started streaming, I did hear a funny story about, and this is late, this is really late, but a friend of mine, or a watcher, had told me the story about how he left his streaming service on and his mic on forever, because that's one of the first things that I did. However, what I did not do was do naughty things in front of said camera while watching naughty things on said laptop. I can't. I'm gonna about. I'm about. I'm on Twitch and YouTube, and even if I am off Ocado, like they don't care. But once he said that, once that story hit my eyes, I made sure to turn my I made sure to turn everything off. And to make sure that everything was off, because it, while I don't do any of those things, I am married, and I do like my privacy, and I don't want anybody to catch me, like if I'm, happen to be a towel and, going to the bath, going to the bathroom to take a shower, Yeah, we don't want to do that. As far as the ice go, I plan to highlight them. Like I normally do? Cell shade style, if that makes any sense. That's okay. My way of doing things is different. I don't add extra color and stuff to anything unless there needs to be like an extra color. I like to just put my flats down all on one shade and then let all of the other light and shade layers take care of color, you know, how the color acts or is or does. That's about the best way I can describe it. I'll show you in a minute. Thank you. I'll tell you about that on Discord. I do have okay, so like where I am right now is Columbia, South Carolina. Or rather kind of out in the boonies off to the side of that. I get normal requests from my shop. They're like, "Hey, can you make me into this elf? Can you make me into this werewolf, this dragon?" Sure, I can do that. I can do regular cartoony things and stuff. By the way, how do you like the. I'm gonna zoom out right quick and you tell me if you like what you see, because then I can go and start, I can start doing the shading and everything. But yes, as opposed to your question about crazy commissions, there is a commission. So, like years ago when I was still doing photography, my friend, I was at a church, and then we had, and then like going past it, and like literally very close to the church, was a comic book shop called Cosmic Rays, who's been there for a long time. Rock on. And he was saved. We're gonna save this now. Anyway. He was really cool, and I told him about my. I walked in one day and I told him about Shirley. I said, "This is really cool. I've never seen anything like this." And he's like, and of course he's like, "Yeah. We love to support, we love to support artists. That's what we do here." I'm like, "That's awesome. Thank you. I really appreciate it." He goes, "Yeah." And I said, "So how much do you want in commission?" He's like, "Or for like a." For a for consignment or anything, what do you want?" He goes, "Oh, I don't want anything." I'm like, "Are you kidding?" He's like, "No, that's the whole point of supporting a local artist, is that I don't want anything from it. And I love supporting local artists because I love comics." Time goes by and I start selling more Shirley, and some of his guys that work in his shop come down to the barnyard every so often and have like a little get together with the other comic people, and they start selling comics as well. And I love Ray. I love Ray. Just a great guy. And And I think this pass, this like at the end of like last year, and kind of at the beginning of this year, he's been wanting me to do these really interesting, not safe for work versions of comic covers, and he's been paying me fairly well for them, for traditional style. Although now that, you know, I've met you, BT, I've been rethinking about my traditional stuff because, but anyway, so I'm sure you know what variant covers are, since you've worked a lot of the artist alleys in Texas and stuff like that, and I just wanted to, you know, and, he wants me to, do all kinds of variants, like, I think it was, Atomic Comics or something, and the first one, you didn't do anything, it was the first variant cover that I had was Styx, and he wanted a Wolverine's daughter to be on the cover of Styx with some nudity in there, so then there was that, and then there was an old variant cover that he wanted me to do, and it was from Planet Comics, and I think it was like their first variant cover. Of course, there's nothing inside of, you know, said variant cover, so, but he loved it. And I don't know if you've heard of this variant, or I don't know if you've heard of this cover before, because this is Western, Zombie Girl. So, he's absolutely in love with Zombie Girl, and I'll get into this, into the actual description of that on Discord, because I don't want to upset anybody and then, like, get kicked off of here, but, yeah, that's what he's been doing, but he wants me to do these traditional covers for these variant covers for like $100. So after you telling me that I am not charging enough, I wasn't charging enough for my, for the full body covers and everything for the body pillow, I'm thinking maybe I should have charged him like $200 for like variant covers like that. But because he was going to try and pay me $50. Zombie Girls. Apparently that is a big thing in the Western comic world right now. But yeah, I think I was trying to come back to his shop because I knew he had a Western comic that I really wanted to read and that I heard a lot about. And they too went on a 3-year hiatus. That was called Saga. And I gotta tell you, that is amazing. I love that comic. And what I'm excited about is that I found out this year they're actually coming out of their hiatus and they're starting to post more. So I'm like, yes! So. That joy in my world. I'm like, yes. I'm so excited. And my husband got me the whole comic, the whole first compendium of it for Christmas. So, or of Saga for Christmas. So I'm like, yay!
No,
thank you, honey! You know what? Saga is amazing. It's like, it's my cure for my Game of Thrones addiction. I don't know if you guys ever did watch, if either of you guys watched Game of Thrones, but like, Saga is like all fantasy, like there are like unicorn people in it. They're like, okay, so like basically Saga is a war between a big planet with a bunch of people with wings, and then there's they're at war with their moon called Wreath, and they're a bunch of horned people, and they're fighting one another, and then there's, you know, all of the other races in their neighboring planets get sucked into this war, and they have like mermaid people, like they have fish people, they have snake people, they have humans, and they even have a lion cat. They have like a planet called Sextillion, which employs, which is basically the red light, it's like the red light district planet, and they have like a slew of workers there, and they're all different kinds. Like there's a beaver lady, I think there's actually a human centipede in there, not like Centipede the movie. Ugh. I did not see all of it. I have heard of it. I've seen bits and pieces I've seen bits and pieces of the movie, but not the whole thing. But anyway, Saga, it's like, and their spaceship. They fly around in a tree spaceship, like, in Tenchi Muyo. Because Ayaka and, anyway, I'm sorry, I got lost in thought. But anyway, yeah, I love that series. It's absolutely amazing, and they even have robots! They have androids! Like, actual androids, and they have somehow in that story of Saga, or in the Saga universe, actually have the ability to breed. And you're not like, when I say like breeding, like human beings could breed, like mammals could breed, but it's like everything, they're like an organic android, and they come from a planet of organic androids. And I don't know. It's so weird, but I love it. But that is my That is my, That was my answer to my Game of Thrones problem. Well, and I really wouldn't say it's a Game of Thrones problem. I love Game of Thrones. The problem is that the story ended, and I was just kind of, I don't know, I've just been kind of like blah, like I really need to find something to get into, like I did, with Game of Thrones, and I couldn't. It was sad. But Saga just kinda, that's my new thing that I want to get obsessed about now, is Saga. Now my sister's tried to tell me things like, oh, you should go in. First off, my mother-in-law wanted to get me into that one series that, you know, the lady time traveled, you know, into the past, and then all of a sudden, you know, like, she's stuck and she can't go back, and now she has to, she ended up marrying this guy, and I'm like, I don't know if I can get into that, you know? Yeah, no, I love Saga. I think it's a great series, and I'm excited to see what will come of it. Hopefully they don't do another friggin' hiatus. That would be sad. I would be sad. Then I would be like, I don't want to deal with sad no more. I just, move on to the next. I am excited to see, and I can't remember what the name of it is. That doesn't surprise me. I think it's the guy who plays Littlefinger. I'm sorry to hear that. nuggets? Are you kidding me? Like, up here, it's like... And of course, they would be all out of nuggets and all that in Florida. Typical Floridians. Like, I heard a story at one point in time about Florida. Because I do remember this one time it did snow in Florida, and it was, what was it? It snowed. There was like a slight flurry for like a second, and of course, none of it stuck. But, that was when I heard the story that it actually, at one point in time, snowed in Miami, and of course, it didn't stick. So, they had to make an investigation, right? They had to send the police out there to make sure that nothing, you know, that an airplane didn't accidentally drop a whole lot of crack cocaine, or toss a lot of crack cocaine out of the sky. Because it was raining in Florida. Only Florida. I mean, that takes Florida Man to a whole new level. But yeah. Chicken nuggets? Like, up here, it's bread and milk. I'm not sure what part of Texas you lived in. Chicken nuggets. All the chicken nuggets are gone. At least they don't have to drive in the snow. Was it a live gator? I mean, what? Like, I mean, people don't normally do that. And are you sure it was a live gator and maybe not an iguana? I hear those things are kind of taking over Florida right now. Along with the pythons, which apparently are down in, the Keys. Or not the Keys, but Miami. Everglades. have had to have been that big and probably threw like a little, like a baby. I mean, how else did you throw? How else would you be able to be able to chuck a gator? And it had to have been a fake. I mean, no life. I mean, they don't do that in Florida. We don't go into Florida, into the wild, and grab gator. The smart people don't do that in Florida. We don't go and grab gators out of, you know, nothing, you know, out of the swamps and throw them at people. At the risk, actually, alright, what do you think? There's so many things that Florida man has done. Saving one more time, just in case. Always good. What do you think? I know it's supposed to be gray, but I thought maybe giving it a little color might make it pop a bit better. Okay, so we're good on that. Now that I've got all of that, you want to do. Alright, so now we're gonna go to Discord for the not safe for work version. Right? Alright, I am starting up Discord. I can. So is it just you? Do you want to do just the not safe for work thing? Just like mano a mano, or did you want to invite some of your other friends? Holy crap, guys. Thank you so much for coming out. I really appreciate it. That is the, I met people from the stream. I've got a. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's 7. That's 7 people, not including you. Give me a second. I actually deleted my old server, but I'm going to add one. Alright, guys. So, I just made a channel. I'm in. I'm going to see about trying to invite people in now. Because I'm still new. You would think I know how to invite people. Dang! Okay. Alright, so this is how we're gonna play it. When we get off of here, I expect everybody to be 18 years or older. When we all jump off of here and get onto the Discord, everybody is welcome. So, here's the link. Here's the link, everybody. Like, it's in the chat. Everybody can come if you want. Or, everybody can join. I will... BT, I will send you an invite via the email as requested. Okay, I've sent you to the Discord. All right, folks, that's it for this Discord. If you are under 18, thank you for coming. Thank you for coming out and watching me stream. If you are not under 18, or if you are over 18, you are most welcome to join the Discord server. And that is in chat. But yeah, I know you're good. I know some of you are good, and some of you are not. Or, I don't know. I don't know if some of you are. But anyway, that is the end of the stream. Thank you all for coming, and hanging out, and watching. I appreciate it. I will actually be back tomorrow, and I will be streaming I will be laying some flats, and for about an hour or so. Alright. Love, peace, and chicken grease!